Totally, cool. All right. Alrighty, things I should have checked before I started. Hey, John, how you doing, man? How you doing? Let's go and let this just billow for a bit. Hey, Gabber, how you doing, man? Let's see, I'm gonna adjust my chair. There we go. Alright, perfect. Hey, Fix It Clary, I haven't seen you in forever. How are you doing? Just gonna let this run for a bit, because this is running through an OSSC and it seems to look pretty decent, but I'm just kinda, I have it stuck at 480p right now because I haven't figured out all the settings, so we'll see how this goes. Oh, you did fix it? Yeah, I did not have one when I was younger. I didn't learn about the 32X till a bit later. I blame a lot of them not having a cable television as a child. I think I didn't get a cable television until like late 95, something I kind of missed a lot of the ad blitz for the 32X. I'm kind of loving the stuff you can do with 32X in terms of the 3D. But anything exciting and fun going on in your lives? So assuming, Gabber, you like this better than the 16x9? Oh, just working? Watching folks sleeping? Hence Star Wars extended more challenging levels. I guess the pilot and gunner have less lasers than the pilot and gunner. Let's get the Y-Wing. It's more of a heavy ship. That's like one more shield, but two less lasers. It's two less wings. Four less wings. It's definitely.
Attention, all wing pilots. Stand by to receive order.
Oh, game ammo's too high? Thought I had adjusted that. Let's turn to about there. Let's see how that goes. Alright. Yeah, that better?
Wipe out enemy fighters.
Wipe out enemy fighters. Slow down. It's you. Jesus. I slowed this thing down. Oh my god. Oh man. Hey, Jeremy, what's up, man? And the first thing I play after saying not to play Star Wars game is put in a Star Wars game. Oh, you couldn't hear me talking? Oh, crap. Yeah. Jeremy, how you doing, man? I had a buddy who had the Sega channel. He figured as much. Couldn't help myself. Yeah, the OSSC brought to you this evening was donated graciously by Jeremy Dixon to the show. How do I slow down? Oh, B is boost, okay. First half of my camper. Oh yeah, you were camping. Hmm. Yeah, but back to Fixie's statement. I had a buddy who had the Sega Channel. Thought that was pretty sweet. Turn very sharp in this game. R2 ate it. There we go. Yeah, I just had to figure out the right output resolution. I haven't quite figured out how to change that up on the OSSC. It seems to do... The initial setting seems to be 480p. I need to figure out how to play with it. It seems like my capture card, as long as I know the output resolution of the device, it can pretty much do anything. So it works out pretty good in that regard. Surprised we never got a Wing Commander for the 32X. I like the MIDI tunes on this would be great. The Yamaha bass on it. Come on, right past me. Hey, Gemini K, how you doing, man? Yeah, Gemini K, I haven't quite gotten that far into it. I wonder how well this is going to act with some of the PlayStation devices. Yeah, I'm kind of curious too. I was testing it initially on that to make sure it worked. And it was working decently, but I didn't really go too in-depth. I was just... just on my TV, not even my capture card was all that. Come on. Okay. It's a great alarm noise. Oh, no. The first far better than the Frame Meister, I think. There's still momentary black screen. Oh, I never actually had the chance to play with the Frame Meister. I know Jimmy Hoppe plays it quite a bit. Hey, Sunbill's doing, what's up, man? Did the Atari Jaguar ever have a chance? No, it did not. Not with the Tremels in charge of Atari, it did not. There's a noticeable difference in between my other cheapy European startup scaler or the Chinese one. Considerably better response time. Like significantly so. Did I ever blame the lag? Did I ever blame it? Hey, Ninja Master, how you doing, man? Is the rule of recruitment lying about medical history equal good lying about crime? Well, medical history is one of those things where most medical records aren't necessarily open to each other. So if you're lying about something in that, there's really... The Army has a significantly harder time... tracking it down, or at least, at the very least, like, knowing about it. So a lot of folks lie about their medical history all the time when they're doing the military just because it's not something that's public record because of HIPAA and all that. I mean, the Army might try and get access to it, but odds are it's not on, like, any networks they have access to. But yeah, criminal history, stuff like that, that tends to be everywhere. Or at least attached to you, and that tends to be, like, the like DOJ type stuff, so it's servers the military has access to. So yeah. So people tend to lie all the time about medical history when joining the military. I mean, when I went through basic, there was like, I want to say there was like 10 people that lied about their medical history, and like a couple of them, they had like serious issues where like they had like severe joint issues, like their arms would be dislocated and stuff like that. So it was one of those things where like they lied about it, and then they started doing push-ups for like, I think it was like a week or so in, and they were just getting tons and tons of work on them, and they weren't expecting to have to work that hard. It's like their arms were popping out of their sockets and stuff, and Army figured it out that this was a pre-existing condition and was pretty pissed about it. But yeah. Oh, we made it?
Yeah, alright.
.486. Yeah, I remember my dad got a 386, well, he had a 386 that he gave my brother, and I played on his a lot, and then he picked up a 486. That was pretty great. See, I've known people that got through. Yeah, I hadn't met anybody in my time in service that, like, they had criminal history, because most people tended not to lie about that. Yeah, I could see how that would come back to bite people in the ass. Oh, okay. As long as you don't have, like, existing signs of it when you go to through MEPS to get your medical check, odds are they wouldn't know. Kind of surprised that would be a, medical permit, to be honest with you. Yeah, for some reason this, like, game, like, the way the MIDI tunes are, reminds me a ton of looking at my brother, when I watched him play through Wing Commander for, like, the first time. Vision could be worse after a few years of training and surgery would disqualify. Can't detect CRT. Huh. Yeah. Yeah, I can't imagine I don't know. I'm not a doctor, so I'm not necessarily know what to look for in that situation. So I'm like, I imagine you could probably get past it. It seems like they do a very thorough check when you go through maps, really. I could be wrong. Oh, yeah. I think, what? Correct me if I'm wrong, but like, Star Wars Arcade is a expansion or continuation, at least for the 32X. It's a follow-up to the arcade game from Atari, I thought. Could be very wrong, though. That is a great noise. Yeah, that's my thought. That's my thought there, Jeremy. How close are we to winning? Like 35%, huh? How you doing, man? I'm doing great. How you been? Hey, Car Freak. How you doing, man? Prototype fighter. Still blows my mind that this is pretty, something capable of like association with the Genesis. Gabber, if you wouldn't mind, man, putting an invite in the chat, or any of you folks. Hey, Zero Man, how are you doing, man? Really? God, they're both terrible beers, though, so that's kind of interesting. Excuse me.
Storm the Imperial Death Star and wipe out enemy fighters.
Yeah, we have, Gabber and them can't give you an invite, I'll send someone here in a sec. sorry, Zero Mentor, I'm drinking a Monaco Black Raspberry Vodka mixed drinks tonight. This game run on Stadia without lag. One of my buddies from work set me up with that. He's like, hey, bud, use my friends and family Oh no, like my friend Stadia thing. So we sent an invite, so I have that set up on my phone and I've yet to try it out. Dude, I was trying to like use it in my office without a controller hooked up to it, and it was not being cooperative. I'm like, I'm not surprised this isn't doing particularly well. It just wasn't a very flatter, like, this wasn't a very fun experience. It was just kind of irritating. Like, even to set up their trial, you still had to put in your credit card information, which I thought was annoying. I'm like, oh, you're just banking on the idea that people will forget about your product when you install. It's the movie pass of video games, what that is. The question is, did I get a kill for that TIE fighter crashing into the wall? I don't think I did. Oh, thanks, John. Appreciate you, sir. Proton torpedoes or photon torpedoes? Because photons are Star Trek, so we're calling proton. Just jingle that ice there. Yeah, I'm gonna be ice in this cup. I'll pour some ice into a glass on the next one. Pour it just to make sure your ASMR needs are fulfilled. Just constantly. God, that's a lot like a 486 video, like PC back in the day. The DOS game. Okay. Let's play some T-Mech for a bit. How about that, guys? Now, I really need to build some kind of wonky overlay to go in here. Yeah. It is harder to join the FBI than CIA. Oh, I imagine they're both rather difficult. Remember, I applied for the CIA like a decade ago when I got out of college. They did not hire me, but I did go onto a record where apparently my application was considered by the NSA a couple of times. So that was cool. Yeah, the NSA kept sending me, like, recruitment emails talking about how they're reviewing my application, and I'm like, ooh, that's neat. But yeah, that never went anywhere. I guess one of the big things about when you try to join those organizations, you don't talk about trying to join those organizations. George Galloway hats and trash casual. God, yeah, the Texas Rangers taught me anything. Or the show U.S. Marshals. Or is it Justified? One of those, yeah. What is the legislative slash law enforcement aspect of the Marshals? I don't even know particularly what they handle. You know, this game, if you... there's a code you can put in to actually play Battlezone. I just can't remember the code right now. No, it's the thing you enter on here. The Marshall Sandal Stagecoach Robbery. I would love if that was still an issue faced by them. And there's a bunch of U.S. Marshals sitting in an office. And they're like, we got one! God, that'd be funny.
Excellent.
Did T-Mac come out in the Saturn? I can't remember. I love this one has a freaking tow missile I can shoot people. Oh, Quartz Witnesses Protection. Okay. Gotcha. Never follow the U.S. Marshal or... Oh, yeah, I guess, Well, you had the movie The Fugitive with Harrison Ford, then you had the sequel with James Earl Jones. No, not James Earl Jones. What's his name? Tommy Lee Jones in the U.S. Marshals sequel. I remember that now. There we go.
Excellent.
Yeah, look at that sprite rotation. That's some handsome stuff going on right there.
You are winning.
Controller might be lagging out here. Not lagging, but... using one of the old Hyperkin 6-button re-releases they had.
Excellent.
Oh. Hey, Alex, how you doing, man? This is Dark Forces. Is the YouTube game thing saying that's what I'm playing right now? Or is there a Star Wars thing going on? Is Shao Kahn commenting it? He might be. I think we won. Yeah. Doing good, just saw you go, oh, okay. I should have the notification. No, I didn't actually make the stream start until I had to. I just got an OSSC from Jeremy Dixon. It took me a minute to figure it out, so I didn't actually start streaming until about 10:13-ish. Well, we'll see. Usually, YouTube seems to hate sharing my stream information, so, or letting anyone know I'm live, for that matter. The only video game that has U.S. Marshals outside of Westerns is Far Cry 5. Oh, okay. I'll pick that. Gotcha. Actually, I'm going to grab another drink, so I'll be right back, guys. Hang on one sec.
Just one sec. So I enjoy the squeaky chair rocking back and forth. All right.
Oh, yeah, there are no live streams. Yeah. Real nice of YouTube to do that. All right, let's play some more T-Mac, shall we? The green haze is just... Ha ha ha! Love you too, Jeremy. God, what is kicking my ass? Holy crap. Is suddenly the computer's now out of fight?
You are losing.
What? No. Crap. Missed my toe missile shot.
Excellent.
There we go, back in the game. Oh, come on. T-Mac? It's not that bad. I don't know. To me, it feels like a fun kind of take on the Battlefield type genre, or Battlezone type genre. Yeah, Battlefield genre. That's what this is.
Cheap revenge.
Let's see, does it have to be a government-run prison, or can it be a private prison? Oh, just seeing the three patterns. Yeah, the lack of transparency in the way they did that. Let's see here. Sorry, catch up on the chatter. Make sure I miss anything. And it's taken to you for third. No, all I know is my application apparently bounced around the NSA offices for a bit. Excellent. For whatever reason. This was, before YouTube when I was in college and I had applied. You know, I figured, like, I'm a smart guy, you know, I could apply to the CIA and all that. So I put an application to the CIA as an analyst, and then I don't think that ever went anywhere. And then I know I started getting notifications from the NSA that they were reviewing my application. I thought that was pretty cool. But no, it didn't go anywhere. Oh, no worries, Rhea. Yeah, there's a couple people that got, like, jobs crazy fast in private prisons. I know the one private prison they had in Idaho was called Gladiator School, because the guards apparently were teaching the inmates how to fight each other and then taking bets. They closed that one down. Did the CIA judge you when you're floated to seduce a woman? I feel like that would be a recruitment criteria, but no, I don't think so. I think it was based on, like, application, background. But ultimately, like, to get an organization like the CIA, stuff like that, you gotta be really, really, really invested in doing, like, internships. And, like, getting, like, that your name out there at those organizations. Oh, come on. Hey, David Riott, how you doing, man? What's your... I like the tow missiles in this one. It's kind of like a Bradley fighting vehicle. Was that the irony that was going to be? Yeah, that might be the case. Maybe that's why I didn't get selected. But God, that was like a decade ago, though. It could have been held up by how long it took to figure out where the HMFDDs were coming from. Oh, man. Is it a correctional officer? No, yeah, I think a few of my buddies have been correctional officers. I'm doing great, man. Just enjoying the weekend. Go this way. Patriots will win anyway. Oh yeah, the puppy bowl, that's still a thing. I forgot about that. God, I didn't even pay attention to the Super Bowl this year. Like, at all. Oh, crap. What? Oh, I didn't continue fast enough? That was good. Yeah, but Alex, how you doing, man? Alright, let's go ahead and switch to something else here. Let's play some Doom for a minute. I appreciate it. Because Doom is coming to video games. Nobody in the East Coast is really excited about this one. Yeah, blew it. Yeah, that's a hurt fly. Doom came to video games. Yeah, this looks really freaking good on the OSSC. I still personally believe this is a better version of the Super Nintendo one, but that's just me. Let's see, thanks, that game was triggering me. I didn't like sand its course and it didn't get set for. prequels, the best. Yeah, something about freaking SNES Doom. It just never. The game didn't play right. Yeah, okay. You don't like the fart bass of the Genesis? I remember when I did my Doom video, I recreated this entire portion from in freaking After Effects, and I was so proud of myself. Music, more levels. I don't think you're the only one, Rio. I've always really dug the just Genesis Master System sound. I very much like you to die. So I would argue that Mortal Kombat's better on the Genesis just based purely on the controller alone. Hey! Tex, how you doing, man? Yeah, I've been watching so much like G-Man Lives recently. I don't know if you guys watch his channel, but he does like reviews of old like FPS games, and he was doing a Kingpin the other day, and I freaking love that shooter. See, I like the Mega Drive sound, but indeed it requires a skilled artist to use it well. Mortal Kombat on the Genesis even sounds better than the arcade. Really? I've heard all kinds of bad things about the Saturn port of this game. Like, even like, what, like Quake and stuff have an issue on the Saturn? Just because of how they did the lighting or something like that, right? There's a story there. Doom Eternal introducing Heaven and Angels in Doom Universe, hoping they will make Angels tougher. I don't know, I was, I thought the latest Doom game wasn't too bad, I guess wasn't, I don't know, I wasn't very happy, I didn't like the, what are they, the glory kills, or whatever you call them? Get more life and stuff like that, I'm like, meh. To me, it just kind of slows down gameplay. Just because it's like the same repetitive thing almost over and over again. To farm money and armor. But overall, I think like a decent game, just I don't know, I wasn't feeling it. Already went up here, not sure when I'm coming back, but yeah. More metal. A lot of things need that. Okay, oh, red door over here. Yeah. Like the arena style gameplay. Yeah, I guess it kind of falls more into that Serious Sam type mechanic. Where you're not like looking for keys, trying to progress the same way you would be with like Doom traditionally. It was more of a go to an area, kill all the enemies, then progress. But I guess it's kind of the same way, but more of an aggressive type, I guess. Be the best way to say that. Yeah, because look at these levels, though. It makes me want to go back and build more in After Effects. This is pretty fun. Like, I almost thought of doing, like, a freaking Sega CD tonight, but I was having a real hard time getting my daughter to switch, daughter go to sleep this evening. Let's see, does that switch lower the chainsaw? This one? Is the chainsaw in Doom 1? I thought that was a Doom 2 one. Could be very wrong. I'm probably remembering this wrong. Oh, the one with the toxic waste? I don't remember now. Oh. Let's go back and find it out. For some reason, I thought the chainsaw was in Doom 2. I don't know why. Could be very wrong. That was in both versions? Okay, thanks, Abe. Super Shotgun. Stream Stadia said no one ever. Oh god, that makes me want to test something. Actually, hang on. Sorry, let's do a quick Stadia test here, because I actually have it on my phone because a coworker here wanted me to test it out. So let's see, I have a. Sorry, you got me interested really quick here. Hang on here and. See what happens if we do this. Very curious. So you take the USB port on my USB 3 port on USB-C. Sorry, I already apparently buzzing. Then use a Xbox 360 controller. And then we check out Samurai Showdown on Google Stadia. What do you guys see? So try and get it to load, let's see what happens. Checking your connection. This is so much easier. Important safety information before you play Stadia. Okay. Yeah, it still takes forever. Oh dear, it's gonna take forever. Okay, so that does work. So you can, with your Stadia, if you have a USB-C adapter to USB, use a traditional 360 controller to get Stadia going. And I really need to play this, try it out, and then cancel it before Google bills me. It's just saying. But yeah. I have a coworker who did like the whole Google Founders Pack and all that stuff, and I'm just like, you know what? Google has abandoned products in the past, which kind of makes me skeptical of their performance. And also, one of the things that kind of really pissed me off about Stadia was when they were like, when they launched the platform, they were what was it? They had like a whole shrine set up outside their like launch site. And they were, like, making jabs at the Dreamcast, and I'm like, fuck you. See, what I think about Doom Eternal so far, it seems like a joke. Joke Doom. I don't know, kind of the outrageous storylines kind of fits with the whole motif that John Carmack and John Romero used to go for back in the It offices back in the day. Like, half the reason why he did Daikatana was because that was like one of their D&D campaigns he did with John Carmack. It was a mistake. But yeah, no, I guess I kind of launched that. I'll have to play around with it later, but I'm not... So far, trying to use it, I haven't been impressed. Because ultimately, it's just... How dare you survive that shotgun blast? How dare you? Yeah, I've heard that story that Doom 3DO was developed by one person. I think, was it Wolfenstein was being worked on for the SNES by one guy who didn't do it, with Hamburger Bill or whatever it was? What was her name? There was a female developer has a YouTube channel, loves telling stories about her experiences developing games. And, like, the guy who was developing it for the 3DO had, like, pulled a bunch of crap or something like that. Okay, I need to go back and watch her video on that, because it's, like, really interesting. But I'm drawing a blank, because apparently old age has eradicated my memory. Fine old age, no more the drinking, but yeah. But yeah, as I said, the research I've been doing into making a video about the TurboGrafx has been a lot of fun. Because I didn't realize, I knew like the TurboGrafx had had an interesting start in the United States in terms of like what they were planning on doing. And it's almost one of those things, it's a story to me that, like looking back on it with hindsight, if you compared how the PlayStation came into being along with the TurboGrafx, like where the PlayStation had the backing of like the single largest like hardware corporation on the planet in terms of them making radios, musical devices, CD players, televisions. So, like, Sony was, like, the perfect fit to sell the console because they were just immensely powerful and had incredibly deep pockets. NEC was kind of the same thing. So you would think them coming into the market earlier would have given them a particular edge on hardware production and things like that just because they were such a wealthy corporation. But no, because they played their cards entirely differently. It's amazing. But yeah. See, I thought it was in that screwed her over. Oh, weird. I don't know. I'll have to check that out. I thought it was like somebody else that screwed. Like I thought it was somebody else in the 3DO project that screwed her or something like that. Then she had to go and port it. I have to check it out. Time for those games to be coded by only one person. At least it ports, right? Hmm. Hey, Red Glass, how you doing, man? Yeah. Spider House is an interesting game. It feels really responsive, but man, that game can just. It's just. I feel like it's designed like a lot like an arcade game at times, where it's designed to hit you. So no matter what, you're going to take damage. Yellow key. Close to a barrel. Nice. Hey, Red Glass, how you doing, man? I haven't seen you in a while. The Spawn vibe. I love Spawn growing up. Actually like the name Doom Guy or Doom Slayer. I was gonna like the name Doom Guy just because it's like a cultural phenomenon just based on the fact he didn't have a name, so we're like, yeah, the Doom Guy. And it kind of just popped up from there. But Doom Slayer sounds a lot like a D&D type title one would get. Oh crap, that went the wrong way. Ugh. Jaguar? Yes, the Jaguar version was the one that didn't have any music, but arguably it was actually a pretty good version of it. I need to pick up Doom on 32X, and that one, I feel like the controller... I've heard good things about that one, that version of it, and I feel like the controller would actually lend itself rather well to a FPS environment, at least in terms of Doom. I feel like AVP is kind of overrated, but that's just me. Yeah. And that might just be the buyer's remorse, because I spent like $70 on that game, and I'm like, no! I thought you were better than this! But then I really had to, really should have tampered my expectations, and been like, you know what, it's a 32X, or sorry, a Jaguar cartridge. Should probably really lower my expectations. Ah! Got me. Relaxing, bourbon sipping, watching you play through. Oh, hell yeah, man. Good to hear. Got me, yeah. I thought my daughter had gone to bed around like 8. But no, she was just laying in bed reading a story. I'm like, no, go to bed! Otherwise, I would have been in the house earlier and actually hit the liquor store and probably gotten something more interesting than just a Monaco vodka cranberry. Yeah. How dare you! That was a shotgun? God, no. Larry, you got an N64 for 12 years. Holy crap. Yeah, I never actually played Doom. The funny thing, when I was younger and I had an N64, I didn't get Doom 64. It's like, it's Doom. I've already played Doom on a bunch of other platforms. Why would I want to get Doom on the N64? Not realizing it was actually basically like a whole new freaking title with a bunch of new like aspects to it. I really need to re-pick that back up. Because I played on an emulation not too long ago, and I was like, yeah, it's actually pretty good. That's Jimmy and Seamus. Man, I'm hoping Jimmy would hop on here if I can bug him. Doom 64 is my Doom 3. I really enjoyed Doom 3 when it came out, but like a lot of people like made fun of it for being just a giant, what would you call it, monster closet thing? Where like ultimately you see health packs and armor in the distance and light, and then you go to it and the floor falls out and you're a bunch of zombies around you. Jesus. That was a great use of my HP. We'll say with the OSSC, it's considerably easier to see further in this game, though. Doom 3 is... That's the way. Now, the way you play Doom 64 is PC port. Oh. Wait, is there a PC port? Or are you talking about like the emulators for that game on there? Doom 3 is a good game, but not a good Doom game. The N64 is such a poor console in terms of games. I'm not sure, like, this has to be, like, nostalgia goggles on my part, but, like, the N64, like, the controller, I just seem to give it a pass. I don't know why. But I don't know why I give it so much slack. The controller never really bothered me. It was rather awkward. But then again, my most favorite game on that console was freaking GoldenEye. And I felt like, in terms of like what consoles were doing at that point in time, it kind of lent itself decently to that, but not perfect. But yeah, definitely could have been better. Muffled Doom 2. People react to creating the game engine on PC. Oh, okay. Oh, Brutal Doom's pretty great. Wait, is it Brutal Doom 64? Damn. Yeah, Brutal Doom was pretty sweet checking that one out, like the mouse aim and the way they had that one set up and just how freaking smooth it looked. Yeah, freaking Brutal Doom, freaking Doom 64. Holy crap. I'll have to check that out, because that sounds pretty freaking great, to be honest with you. That sounds awesome. Let's see where I get over to that other room through here. God, freaking, like, I don't know how many of you guys have read, Masters of Doom, but, like, just reading about, like, how, like, they made the WAD files and all that, and how they just designed Doom after, when they learned how people were modding it so prolifically, and how, like, Doom 2 and those ones were, they just made it that way to just be inclusive, and then they sort of, like, basically, like, shopping the mod creators, and that was, like, basically their job application for id. This is so damn interesting. This is an entirely different time in gaming. I'd very much like you to die now. Should I break some more? What? I'm drunk. I hate the N64. I feel like when I'm drunk, that's when the N64 falls right back into, like, good old nostalgia goggles for me. It makes it like, well, yeah, you know what, this isn't so bad. For some reason, when I'm drunk, I feel like I have free hands and the controller works just right. But then again, I'm just... The only console I hate when I'm drunk is the Sega Saturn, which apparently is blasphemy for a lot of folks. That's about the only thing I hate when I'm drunk, though. See, it runs on ZDoom. ZDoom supports things. The original engine. Don't. Huh. So Nintendo tried to appeal to the Atomic Bomb survivors in marriage. That explains why the N64 is so goddamn durable. They weren't trying to sell the N64 to you. They're selling it to the survivors of the apocalypse and the Mad Max wasteland that emerged after the nuclear holocaust. With their three arms and their tenacity and only access to CRT televisions with S-Video, will find that the N64 is the ultimate platform that caters to their exact need. The odds are they're going to have some type of, like, muddy eye, so that way they're not too mad about the anti-aliasing added on the console. Man, that's Nintendo thinking next level kind of shit. That's like... They weren't just thinking about, freaking selling card games in Kyoto in 1890. They wanted to go beyond that. I can understand the hate for the Saturn. Back in the day, it was a total fail. I don't know, it's one of those, I don't know, the Saturn gets a lot of praise. Like, I can see why someone who had access to a lot of the Japanese titles for the Saturn would say it was a decent console, because you had a lot of, like, beautiful 2D art games that never saw the light of day in the West. And that really could have been a redefining moment for the Saturn, because you had guys like Bernie Stolar took over after Tom Kalinske was just so morally defeated by Sega of Japan, just because they had... I don't know, it's a really intriguing thing, and I wish Nakayama would talk, like, on the record, because he was the guy who hired Tom Kalinske and then ultimately began eroding his support with the company. But I don't know, again, like the... What would you call it? Like, the 32X... Despite it being an idea from Nakayama and Sega of Japan that was handed off to the Americans. And the Americans made, I feel like they made a really good console, because Tom Kalinske and them were stated as saying they felt the 32X would be a continuation of the Genesis, and therefore a continuation of the 30 million install base they had, 20 million Genesis users from the United States. Which ultimately, that's... kind of a unique idea, allowing a install base of a prior generation console to expand its use beyond what it could do at the time. Sorry, I'm kind of buzzing now. That's a drink, but yeah. So you ever rewatch the real Ghostbusters cartoon? It was the next Ghostbusters? It was the one where it was like they had the girl and some other stuff. Like, that was the one I watched. I never really watched the real Ghostbusters that much. I watched the movies, the Ghostbusters, a ton. But the animated series wasn't, like, readily available when I was younger. I still feel like this controller is damn good for the freaking Doom game. Because you got a dedicated button for strafe, fire, change button, or change weapon. So what was going on here, I wonder? See, to be honest, the Saturn is really great, if you get the Japanese one. No, yeah, it's like the Saturn fell victim to the culture that was occurring at the time. I mean, like, and the Saturn, even, like, its design fell victim to reactionary tactics that were going on in the industry, just because... I mean, like, so the Saturn wasn't the 3D... wasn't, like, so 3D... equipped, and once they got word of the PlayStation's the PlayStation tech specs, they were just completely reactionary in terms of what they brought out. Ah, here's that freaking swastika. Oh, they changed it. Look at that; it's almost a swastika, but not quite. They got rid of this part and this part to make it not a swastika on the Sega version. I didn't realize that. Crazy. But yeah, the Saturn was definitely a victim of that particular era, because, like, Bernie Stolar was quoted as saying, like, none of that 2D shit, only 3D stuff for North American Saturn stuff, because PlayStation was a predominantly 3D console. Even though the Saturn's, like, primary freaking, like, wheelhouse and, like, what it was best at was 2D stuff. Now I jump. It's not going to be a jump, it's going to be a raised the walkway, isn't it? Excuse me. Really? I didn't know that, Jeremy. Sega CD was popular here in Texas. I think good players should actually jump. So, speedrunners. I don't think I have a dedicated jump button. Down in the third deck version, anyway. What's the mode button to do something? No, doesn't appear. I do not have a jump button. Yeah, there are probably speedrunners that know exactly how to get over this without any issue. Oh, I need the yellow key. I'm dumb. Okay. Too busy killing stuff. Oh, charger got me. You can't jump. Thank you, John. Alright, be right back. Gotta grab another beer really quick. Okay.
And I'm back. Hey, Sam Fisher, how are you doing? Oh, yeah, the one for freaking PlayStation 1. I'll check one out. What's your favorite failed game console that's not the CDI? I guess technically the Dreamcast would be considered a failed console. But, yeah. Let's see, if you press X, Z, mode, and up while pausing the game, it turns the God button. Oh, no. Yeah, thankfully that's not the case. Finish off these guys. Here we go. Oh. Yeah, I guess, let's see. 32X is up there. Let's go ahead and switch to something else. Let's check out Knuckles Chaotic for a minute. This game's pretty interesting. It's a very attractive game, and I find this game, for whatever reason, has issues with some versions of Genesis. For whatever reason, it's kind of interesting. Now, let's see if this version actually works with this Genesis. Do I have any Starfleet? I do have Starfleet Academy, actually. Well, this is probably one of the weirder Sonic games. Who else knows how to beat Psycho Mantis so they switch controllers? Jeez. Hey, does the game really need to be on 32X? Yeah, this is one of those games where I think it just had a larger color palette. It's just not... No, I know it's kind of two-player, but
I have no idea why this one would particularly be required to go through 2X. Probably could have lowered some quality aspects of it. Oh, Jesus.
I forgot why I did that.
There we go. That's just... These controllers from the Switch. Can't beat your mind. Hey, Dev, how's it going, man? Drinking, I gotta work tomorrow. Thankfully, I do not. Yeah, I have 2 32Xs that still work. Found it's really. A lot of 32Xs fail because of the ribbon cable that connects around the front of the console, and it's like it's barely held in by just pressure alone. So all you gotta do is go. A lot of the models, you just gotta open them up and then just like readjust that ribbon cable in them. That's pretty easy. I think a lot of people think the 32Xs fail just because they don't have a good, like, seat for it. Because if you have, like, any failures in that connection at all, things won't work. Or if you happen to have a 32X plugged in alongside a Sega CD, and you don't have one of them powered on, you have a failure point. It's kind of weird. They did nothing wrong. Oh dear, did he just die? What the hell? Keep wanting to spin dash, but that's not how you do this in the game. Your 2X was a mistake. I don't think it was. I think the 32X unfortunately had the misfortune of appearing on the market at the same time as the Saturn. Well, not necessarily similar to Saturn, but showed up at third-party developers its dev kit showed up at the exact same time as the Saturn, so it really caused confusion among the industry for folks who were like, who do we support? This thing or the next generation console? Disney should only make Netflix, Daredevil, and Punisher crap canon. Yeah, Daredevil and Punisher were fantastic. Luke Cage and, God, what was the, female's name? God, I hated those ones. Yeah, Luke Cage and freaking Daredevil were good. No, sorry, no. Luke Cage was bad. Punisher and Daredevil were good. Up certain Genesis games, play reinserting the cable, I mean. If you're playing it through a 32X dev, then maybe. But if that's not working on your Genesis, it might just be... It'd probably be like corrosion in your cartridge, maybe. You take some rubbing alcohol on Q-tips and clean the hell out of your contact points. Probably where I'd recommend starting if you're having that kind of problem. Yeah. Yeah, definitely, like, releasing the 32X in such close proximity to the Saturn was seriously a mistake. Like, it had a lot of opportunities and had a good idea going for it in terms of, like, expanding the... basically making the already installed base for the Genesis still relevant by expanding what the console could do. I don't know, it's a neat idea that hadn't been tried, really. And unfortunately, just Sega played their cards completely wrong by how they introduced it. Like, they... literally, the Saturn came out in Japan before the 32X came out in the United States. And so it was just this really ass-backwards way of doing it. So if they just waited and bided their time better, it would have been much more effective. But then again, I also believe the Saturn, they shouldn't even have gone with the Saturn. They should have just waited and bided their time longer and come out with a more definitive next-generation challenger. But this is all hindsight, though, so it's really, yeah. Hey, Gemini, how's it going? Oh, through your 32X. Yeah, honestly, it's probably... Do you have a Sega CD plugged in at all for those? I had a really interesting, odd thing happen with my 32X, where if I have my 32X seated on a Genesis plugged into a Sega CD, and I don't have power going to the Sega CD, the 32X game won't actually boot up. Like, it's usually really prevalent with NBA Jam, for whatever reason. But that's the only one I've noticed that with. But I think probably it'd be the cables. Yeah, if you just pop the top off and pop the RF shielding off the 32X, you can feel how the cables are seated, and you can just kind of plug them back in. And that fixes like 90% of 32Xs. That's usually where their failure point is. Cage and Iron Fist were designed to be campy to begin with. Yeah, I don't know. God, Iron Fist was really annoying. Okay. Yeah, because I bought a broken 32X off Amazon, and they were like, broken, whatever, and I was like, I'll check it out. And it's almost always the ribbon cables that wrap around the front of the console that are busted. If not, it might be a Pico fuse, but if you're running other games through it, then it's probably your Sonic cartridge than the one you're talking about. Oh yeah, there was initially, yeah, Jeremy, when I was it, friggin' Service Games, the History of Sega talks about how initially that cartridge slot in the Saturn was like a design concept for expansion of 32X games and Genesis games to make it like a reverse compatible. I think if they had done that, it would have made the freaking Saturn a lot more attractive. But just, I don't know, Sega had always been a relatively poor company financially in terms of like what they could realistically field. So reverse compatibility wasn't something they could afford. It was like with the power base station they released for the Genesis to make it reverse compatible with Master System games. They did it almost as a FU to Nintendo, because the Super Nintendo was no longer reverse compatible with other NES games. So they released that power base converter in limited quantities just to kind of like tease Nintendo. See, why didn't they do it? Gabber, it would have to be, like I was saying, it has to be like, Sega has never been a financially very rich company. So, like, they just couldn't afford to realistically do it, because they were already selling the Saturn at $399, and that was already at a somewhat of a loss, theoretically, but yeah. Yeah, holy crap, if Saturn could have done that, could have done Genesis and 32X games, it would have made it a freaking mainstay for freaking console players later. But there was talk, at least initially, because they developed that console slot in the back for them. At least I think the initial talk was, at least according to service games, but I could be wrong. But then again, they went the whole memory cartridge expansion thing. I don't think it had the 68,000. I know it had, because the 32X had two Hitachi SH2s, so theoretically you could do 32X games on it, but it probably had a 68,000, because things were everything. I have to look at it, to be honest with you. Yeah, I think, even if it had that, though, I imagine a lot of those guys would have had to have, they would have just software emulated it some way or another to figure it out. Yeah. Oh, man, Rio, I am a firm believer that if they had gone with, like, gone the Neptune route, that Sega would still be on the map today. That's, like, my entire theory. Like, if the Neptune had been released and their plan was they would go Genesis, then Neptune, and the Neptune would usurp the Genesis and just stop manufacturing Genesis consoles, I think the Neptune would have done insanely well. Because it would have offered a 32-bit platform and still played a lot of the 16-bit consoles from Genesis. It still would have played all of them, for the most part. But yeah. Will I get Macaulay Culkin a guest star? Let me go and talk to his channel and see if he'd be willing to fly out to Idaho to appear. Guts out loud with that. I don't think I'm quite big enough. For the most part. But yeah, it is really fun. Like, I don't know, like the, because he did that whole, like, big kick initially where he hit, like, Red Letter Media, then he did AVGN, and I don't know if he hit anybody else, but those were the two big channels I watch regularly that he was on. They're like, that was pretty damn funny. Let's see here. I think the biggest issue with Sega is at the time communication. Oh, yeah. Yeah, Sega and Japan, the fact that they were actively working against each other really did not help Sega's development environment or their cooperation between Japan and America. And it was one of those things where, like, Japan somehow got in edgewise in the next generation with basically backing the Saturn fully. And so they had this, like, relative, I'm going to put in quotes here, domination of the Japanese market, despite the fact they only sold a couple million units in Japan, and it really didn't even come close to what the PlayStation would eventually have. And so somehow they managed to convince Sega that the Japanese arm of the company was significantly stronger than the North American one, which ultimately North America was where they were getting most of their money. And they just had convinced basically the Sega fathers in Japan that they're like, no, we're doing it right here in Japan because we're doing this and we're not spending a lot of money. Because historically, Sega and Sega of America had, they spent a lot of money to make money because it was like they would market stuff and they would get money back. So Sega was never very comfortable with how Sega of America would sell the console because Sega of America was very heavily invested in advertising and selling it. And so it's just kind of a complex kind of scenario there. But yeah. But what 32X titles do I own? I own Knuckles Chaotic, Mech 2, Doom, Star Wars Arcade, NBA Jam, Space Harrier, Shadow Squadron, Star Trek Bridge Simulator, Virtual Racing, 36 Holes of Golf, Motocross, Cosmic Carnage, Metalhead, Virtual Fighter, Virtual Racing, Tough Man, and Mortal Kombat 2. So let's go ahead and switch over to Metalhead because I enjoy this game quite a bit. Here, guys. There we go. Yeah, let's do Star Trek Bridge Simulator next. That was pretty fun. I found it was actually, even though I don't think it looks as good as the Super Nintendo version, it's actually a pretty fun game on that one. I think it's a bit better. Yeah. 5 years after the establishment. Yeah, NBA Jam on the 32X is my favorite version of it. I prefer that to even the arcade, to be honest with you. Wait, is there a 32X for freaking Wheel of Fortune? I have to check that one out.
To maintain public order, a powered bipedal armed robot, or Metalhead, was created.
See, the Japanese do not like Americans. Special Armed Forces, part of the Federation Police. Yeah, freaking Jeremy, one of my best friends, he worked for a Japanese chip manufacturing company, and man, yeah, the Japanese arm of that company did not like listening to the Americans at all, even though the Japanese guys were burning money hand over fist in certain respects.
Of the countries of the Federation.
Yeah, Metalhead is, I really enjoy this game. I don't know why it gets so much hate. Like, it's, I don't think it's that bad. But, I don't know. Even comparing it to, like, some PlayStation 1 games, it's not that bad. Soon overtook an entire country. Connor Corn, how's it going, man? Just won the lottery. £6.90. Hell yeah. Yeah, yeah. Give my daughter a gnome scratcher, and she won $1. So, that was pretty cool. She seemed pretty happy about it. Yeah, this actually could be a 3DO game. To be totally honest. Oh, man. Yeah, Dev, one of my good friends, Genovi, did a whole in-depth video talking about the 32X version of Mortal Kombat 2, which I do have on 32X being one of the best versions. I mean, it's a shame for, like, I picked that one up. I picked that game up because of his advice, actually. But, like, my favorite Mortal Kombat game is still Mortal Kombat 3. Your first mission. Destroy all enemies. I love that you have two versions of this game. You have the, remember to take them all out. The one that has the anime characters, which looks way better, and then you have the one that has, like, Stephen King. For some reason. See, the only thing that really, like, the only thing that bugs me about this game is you have a time limit for whatever reason, which is oddly out of place on a home console game. Like, they still had that arcade influence around there. I don't know why they did that. It's kind of interesting. And I find I'm going to go ahead and use the word interesting a lot because I've been drinking quite a bit, so that tends to limit my vocabulary, so I apologize. Here. This reminds me of MechWarrior. Yeah, it kind of does in that respect. Let's see what they're going for. This guy has to be a gift by now. Hey, Jeremy, did you ever pick up a new mic, or are you still using that like same old one that picks up like everything? Let's see, wow, Jimmy's faces look uncanny. I feel like it's needed more time for developers to really take advantage of it. Yeah, it's one of those things where, like, the 32X, like, I feel like half the reason why the console did as bad as it did was because the 32X was released at the same time as the Saturn, relatively. Like, so, like, the 32X dev kits were showing up at the exact same time as the freaking Saturn was. So, I mean, like, as a third-party developer, you're like, you get two freaking dev kits, and you get the one for the Saturn, and you're like, oh, that's pretty powerful. And then you get the one, well, you get the one for the 2X, you're like, that's pretty interesting. And then you get the next one for the Saturn, you're like, this is dramatically more powerful in some respects, even though it's, like, kind of more complex to program for. So, like, but who do we develop for? Because we have these two kits here, so what do? And so Sega really didn't have a clear, defined vision for the future, and that just ultimately really hurt them in the long run. Hey, Colin, how you doing, man? It's like 2006 PS3 versus 2012. Yeah, Jeremy, I really, because I have all those Japanese games you sent me, and I really want to do a, we need to do the live stream while you're there, because you sent me the OSC and that, so that'd be pretty awesome to do. Because you have to get dialed in to make sure you don't hear everything going on in your house like last time. Oh, just woke up, huh? It's a pretty fun call. Excuse me. Yeah, man, I'm freaking right there with you, man. I would love to find a 32X dev kit. Well, what was that game that came out recently that was a guy who had a Sega CD freaking Genesis dev kit? What was that game called? Like, we were a fox or whatever doing puzzle stuff. But it's a pretty interesting game. Yeah. Didn't have a clear path towards the future. Clearly, you jest. No, Sega just didn't have a good vision. I think if they had, like, given it more towards Tom Kalinske and let him pretty much decide the future of the company, I think they would have been in much better water. But just because you had that whole Japanese pride thing going on between Nakayama and his board, and the fact that they were still kind of fighting him on a variety of other things. But even then, like, freaking Tom Kalinske was like, man, let's freaking Silicon Graphics was like, hey, we have this great technology, let's use this, it's a 64-bit chip. And Sega Japan was like, no, we have the Saturn, we're good, don't worry about it. Yeah, freaking Tom Kalinske, man. Great. It's amazing how huge a company like Sega didn't have a rock-solid plan for the future this time. Oh man, Sega was always kind of like a Wild West company in regards to how they were founded, because, like, you had David Rosen, who was this Japanese, or no, sorry, American Air Force individual who came over to Japan started importing those gambling devices. So the game was founded on kind of a rocky start. Even Dave Rosen was like, you know what? Why are we making game consoles when we can make more money selling software? So we have the best software developers on the planet. But God, it's so damn fascinating. Yeah, Sega definitely, they split the resources and the concept. I think a lot of the issues, I think, in terms of, like, late-game Sega came from, like, late-game being, like, before, like, right when the Saturn came out. They had this whole perspective of, like, the 32X wasn't something they necessarily wanted to pursue. It was something that was kind of forced upon them by Nakayama.
Is that the point? I got the equipment.
I love the people faces, like the anime ones are so much better, but they decided to do these just cause. Yeah. Hmm. Yeah, Trip Hawkins is a true freaking god, man. Yeah, Trip Hawkins, that's an entirely different story. Like, his concept in terms of, like, Trip Hawkins going after a standardization of game consoles to make it like a VCR. It's kind of a brilliant, beautiful idea. But it doesn't fall in line with how technology progressed for game consoles back in the day. It's a great idea for media production if you're willing to leave your what would you call it? Your maximum level of production value at a certain height. Trip Hawkins' idea would have been amazing if people were willing to leave games at a certain development ceiling for that particular period of time to make it like a standardized VCR. It's a beautiful idea. It's unrealistic in terms of how technology was going and how console manufacturers wanted to get the one up on each other. So it's quite amazing in that regard. Yeah. See, I don't know how true the software developer thing is. Oh, Jimmy, how you doing, man? Are you free to jump on a Skype call and just BS for a while? Less Gemini, I feel like the Dreamcast with Sega's future. Oh, man, yeah, absolutely. Goddamn it, stream. the Dreamcast was an amazing console, and the fact that the Dreamcast was just too... It was just too late, unfortunately. If Sega had not wasted a lot of their war chest trying to market the Saturn, I feel like if they had... I don't know. The Dreamcast is amazing, because, like, Sega spent $500 million marketing the Dreamcast, and it still failed, essentially. So it's just fascinating in that regard.
Hammer Knuckle. Chain gun. How do you want to equip your left arm? You'll probably need some optional weapon.
Can join a few? How long is a few?
You'll probably need some optional parts.
Missile launcher.
You finished?
Later, chump. Wow, okay. Freaking Ernest Hemingway. Alright.
Your first mission. Destroy all enemy mechs in the city near the border. Remember to take them all out.
Okay, alright. Let me go ahead and launch my Skype here. Hang on one sec. All right. Let's see, too soon, because it was a great feature, as a touch. Yeah. I don't know, even then, like, I still feel like the Dreamcast offered a platform that... It still had a, like, it had deeper visual resources than the PlayStation, but just not some of the deeper RAM assets required to make it more feasible for games like Grand Theft Auto. Well, Grand Theft Auto 3, anyway. Because you had Grand Theft Auto titles on the Dreamcast, but not 3. Which, I don't know, I know there are some guys out there that have tried to port the game to it, but, man, Dreamcast, to me, will always remain probably one of my favorite consoles of all time, just because I'm still, to this day, a huge Sega fanboy, and I feel like the Dreamcast could have done dramatically more, had it been supported properly, but I think a lot of that happens to fall on the shoulders of Bernie Stolar, who unfortunately soured relationships with him and EA. But even then, that's almost an unwinnable battle, because you look at what EA wanted to do and what Sega had already accomplished in terms of, like, the Studio Black making the 2K Sports series, where Sega had basically made probably some of the best football titles of the last, I guess I could reasonably say the last 20 years, that Sega had come up with some great freaking titles for football. And EA, unfortunately, because EA is such a prolific game maker, without them producing content for the console, it just sank it. Which, man, it's a tough call. I think Bernie Stolar, being prideful in what his company had achieved, I think he was justified in his concept and thoughts. But EA was still just such a dramatic force in Sega's history. In terms of, like, what they had supported the console, like, the Genesis through, like, EA, what? I think if you break down just base numbers, brass tacks, EA made a third of Sega's games for the Genesis. So if EA had been out there producing titles for the Dreamcast, then that potentially could have been a lot more draw to the console, but I think EA was still completely unreasonable for them to say, if we make games for the Genesis, we have 100% unmitigated, we're only the only people allowed to make sports titles for it. Which, I guess, is kind of crazy, especially like when Sega, a company that had, for the most part, been a defining founder in the game industry, it's kind of like ridiculous that EA could demand that, but that's... God, EA just had really just the clout to pull it off. It's because they had focused so solely on that's not following game console creation, but following big game creation. Yeah. It's just nuts. Could chat about Sega all these days, Skype. Could chat about Sega all day, Skype calls open. Yeah, I'm going to take you up on that. Let's see, I missed the older game ads where they weren't afraid to offend people. Oh man, I missed that so dramatically, like where like game console manufacturers were not afraid to go head to head with one another. Like, I feel like his game console ads now are just weak as hell, because you just don't see them anymore. Like, you don't see Xbox going at PlayStation, and you see the PS4 just dominating the game market, and you're like, come on man, come on Xbox, you can do this. And the only thing you really hear from Xbox is when they announce a new console iteration, which is just nuts that they've released as many as they have. But granted, they've released consoles that are dramatically more powerful than other ones in terms of the 4K offerings they have, but... I don't know, it's just nuts they don't have that same shit-talk mentality they used to have in the 90s. I just kind of miss that. Oh my god, Stadia ads are just dumb as hell. They don't, it's like, Stadia ads are almost like they don't even know what they're selling. Yeah. Everyone's friends now. They're like, oh, you don't understand, if we do these shit talk ads, we may not be in the next freaking Smash Bros. Game, so we can't have that. I say the Dreamcast, the Xbox would be nice too. Yeah, I mean, essentially, backbone-wise, yeah, the Xbox kind of is the freaking Dreamcast too, because basically, in terms of how Sega and Microsoft were working together, Sega taught Microsoft everything they knew about how to make a console. And friggin', it was basically Microsoft learned all they could from Sega while they were doing it. They're like, yeah, this is freaking great ideas.
Mission complete.
Yeah, we did it. So, yeah. But, I mean, there was a brief moment where Sega and Microsoft were negotiating, where, like, Sega was like, hey, could you support the Dreamcast on the Xbox? It wouldn't have taken too much for them to do it. They're like, nah, now we're not gonna. But they almost did.
Stage one. Mission two. Destroy the stationary mechs under maintenance in the area. But stay alert. It could be an enemy trap.
Yeah, Rio, that's kind of how it feels now, where, like, a lot of the game consoles are just PC platforms that are kind of neutered for the most part. That's kind of how it feels. I'm gonna get another beer. I'll be right back, guys. Hang on one sec.
All right.
And we're back. It's watching us, I feel it. So yeah, I should just make a Steam box. All games on that platform. Oh yeah, remember when Steam boxes were a thing? Like, you had Alienware manufacturing consoles and you can buy them at freaking Walmart? God, those are the days. Doom Slayer and Smash Bros. The Master Chief. I'm honestly kind of surprised freaking Doom Guy is not in Smash Bros. Jimmy, where are you? Come on, bro. Stadia's the best console. You're really looking for a Dreamcast. What was it? Like, I remember, like, the Stadia, like, when they launched it, they had some weird box booth thing. It was, like, shit talk of Dreamcast out in front. And I'm like, God, what the fuck? Dreamcast didn't deserve that. Dreamcast tried to standardize the online play between players, man. That is an innovative concept that did not exist for game consoles back in the day without buying a peripheral attachment. But then again, like, Sega had been pushing the whole online mentality for a while, but I mean, like, it's... come on. It's like Google didn't know about OnLive. Well, didn't Google buy OnLive or some particular patents owned by OnLive to try and push their platform? But I think people are just innately uncomfortable with that type of platform or distribution model when you're like, you know, I want to buy games for my kid, you know, but I got to go to their online marketplace to buy stuff for it. But yeah. xCloud, so much better. Yeah, it's free. Hey Jimmy, you on Skype, man?
I am fantastic.
That's
hold on
good
one second. Let's see. I was watching your stream, but it was actually at the Star Wars part.
Oh, were you?
Yeah. I don't know. That's kind of strange.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, you know, it was kind of like must have hit a button or something. I also didn't get any sort of notification about this stream.
Yeah, so. People historically never do. If you start streaming after 10 p.m., apparently it just doesn't send it out at all.
Man, why you gotta keep liking all those Richard Spencer videos? They shadow banned you.
Yeah, I know. I think YouTube hates me. I don't know what I did. Like
you saw your haircut, maybe.
That's gotta be it. there was that brief window where they were talking to me, like, yeah, it's pretty exciting to talk to you and all that. We're excited to have you on board and all that and making YouTube videos. I'm like, oh, sweet. And then they just started like, then nothing.
He said, and then Yahel came in and said, don't ever talk to my wife ever again. I'm sure there's some sabotage here.
That's gotta be it.
But yeah, that Star Wars game looks pretty good.
Yeah, it's keeping it a 4x3. I assume you and Bob RGB would probably love it.
Well, no, you gotta keep doing 69 because then we don't have anything to make fun of you.
I know. I gotta. I don't know. I was sitting there. I was trying to find a setting within the OSSC that Jeremy Dixon sent me.
Uh-huh.
To make it a 16x9, but I'm having a hard time finding it. I found with the PlayStation 1, you can do line doubling to get a 16x9 look. But with the Sega Genesis, you can only do double line scaling, so you can't actually get the the 16x9 effect I wanted. I was like, no!
I can't get that 16x9 aesthetic.
No, I can't get that 16x9 make Bob RGB really mad. It made me sad.
Well, that's too bad. Mm-hmm. Take a look at it. No CDIs ever, and I guess Colin got his box. Good. Now he's got a double fist in Sega Saturn light guns. So
that's badass.
Pretty good. That's good to hear. So what is this upscaler?
OSSC.
Okay. Good. Just wanted to make sure.
Looks pretty good.
Yeah. I'm so happy that you finally after how many years of using the Adam Koralik special.
I told you to say the firmware. Yeah, Jeremy sent this to me, so I was like, hell yeah, man.
Oh, there you go.
But apparently he tried to disable all Star Wars games, but I found a way around that, apparently. But he had turned off 16:9. I'm like, man, I gotta show everybody how awesome I am by 16:9 and everything.
Replace Star Wars characters with Duplos. Be terrible.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna be honest, I'm really shocked at how hard these Monaco vodka cranberries are hitting me right now. So, putting that out
Monaco
there.
Vodka cranberries.
Yeah.
Sir.
Yeah.
You're one step closer to start drinking Zima.
Mm-hmm. But I don't know, the American alcohol pre-made mixed drink scene has exploded in the last year and a half, so I'm like, damn.
Is that what that White Claw bullshit is all about?
I have no idea what that is. Because White Claw, that's like, what? That's like White Zinfandel, right? Is that what White Claw is?
I have no idea. I just know it's trendy. Somebody in the chat must.
I've heard things about that where like people are talking about the White Claw. It's like, cause it's like white wine, right? I don't know.
I guess it's like they're seltzer water with alcohol. Okay, thanks, Deb. And yes, they do make Zima. They make it in Vietnam and they import it to Japan, where I drink it sometimes as a joke. It tastes perfectly fine though. Colin, no problem.
Drink it sometimes as a joke.
This is, I was gonna say, I don't know if it's just the stream quality. Maybe look at this. Who am I sending? Yeah, I guess I have 360p. Try 720. There you go, that looks even better.
There you go.
I was gonna say, there's a lot of artifacting or whatever.
No, I need to spend some time and actually make a cool stream overlay for this, or some ridiculous overlay.
Yeah, well, let me know what you need. I'll get you the one that you, I guess you the one that you want.
Let's see, Dev asked favorite beer. My favorite beer is actually Voodoo Ranger from New Belgium. Is one of my favorite like craft beers.
Oh yeah.
Do you have a favorite beer? Yeah.
Me a Ginga Kogan beer, but only on tap. And that's
Ginga Kogan.
Yeah, Ginga Kogan. Would it be like Galaxy Plateau? It's a beer from, I think, is it from Iwate or one of these nearby prefectures from where I live. It's really good, but it's good in the can too and everything. It's kind of expensive, but if going there and getting it on tap is amazing. Other than that, though, anything. Belgian beer is good. German beer is good. Mm. All the generic Japanese beers are actually pretty good for what they are.
Yeah.
I used to love Blue Moon and Shock Top when I was in the States.
I do like Blue Moon.
Just for like cheapo beers.
It was really funny. So last year when I was stuck doing this whole like, I do this what do they call it? Advanced leadership training. And I was at this airport in Las Vegas waiting for the bus to go out to the Fort Irwin and the Death Valley. And so like we're basically like, all right, fine, whatever, let's just drink beer and wait for our buses to come out there. And like the general was just fucking making fun of people for drinking Blue Moon. He's like, that's celery beer shit. He was just walking around making fun of us. It was fucking funny. Yeah. Mission
incomplete. Yes, it tastes good.
Yeah, it's good. He was calling it celery beer, but like, I'm more of an IPA guy, so I'm just like,
I'll drink whatever, man.
Yeah. Mission 3.
I always try to mix it up too. Go to the store and buy like a bottle of different things. Guy might buy some of that Birra Moretti from Italia. Get some of that, you know, like any like the what was it? Singha beer is pretty good.
Hmm.
So whatever is like not too expensive and tastes good.
Let's do some virtual racing on 32X. Let's do that.
Sounds pretty good. Dev SWZ says his personal favorite is Dead Guy. Is that Rogue that makes that, or? Cause I know I've seen. It tastes like a little dead guy, kind of like a little skeleton guy huddled up, sitting down on the floor. I think a little funny hat on. Might be a Pope hat. Who knows? Colin Swinburne, I will take your put aside pennies anytime to send you some more glorious Sega Saturn accessories and video games.
Yeah, we'll say I'm pleasantly surprised by how good Area 51 is on the Saturn.
Yeah, good.
Yeah, that's the first time I've been like, what'd you call it? Like, impressed by the Saturn. Impressed yeah. by the
there you
Saturn.
Go.
Like, all right, I'm like, all right, you did a good job there, Saturn.
Everything on the Saturn is impressive, sir. And the only thing, only, and you know, it's more, you know, it's
only
more
the
impressive?
Stuff released in Japan.
No. The thing that's more impressive is your this charade you keep playing where you like pretend that you oh this art is terrible. It's an impressive charade you've been keeping up. This is a long term storytelling telling people. Ian deserves the Oscar for this. This is like a what is it? The fuck's that guy's name? Andy Kaufman type of act.
Man of the Moon.
Everybody knows the Saturn's awesome.
Dying of cancer because I'm faking my hatred of the Saturn.
Yeah, and then all of a sudden you see the light, and I'm peeled. I see the light. Now give me the monies. changing thermal paste on the Mega Drive.
Oh wow!
I had to change thermal paste on my computer. That's why I can use it to stream. Thanks to Bob. Speaking of streams, I remember a couple weeks ago we were talking about it. You gonna come hang out and stream later tomorrow afternoon for you?
You streaming?
I was thinking about it. Hopefully I don't crash.
Yeah, depending on time, I will try and be there.
Okay, sounds good.
I might be buying a car, so we'll see what happens.
Oh.
Yeah, because you remember, like, my wife wrecked the car when we went up to Portland?
Yeah, I thought I was going to take some duct tape and...
Yeah, so I manhandled the car back together, but, like, I'm really not happy with the engine performance in the car now, based on what my wife did to it. So I'm like, I just may force us to buy a car tomorrow, so we'll see what happens.
Okay, well... Hopefully you find a good one if you do.
No, I've already kind of figured out what I want for the most part. I don't know how you feel about Mitsubishi.
Cybertruck. Oh, Mitsubishi's good. Good company.
Yeah, I don't know. I was having a weird, funny daydream like a little bit ago. How funny it would be if like Mitsubishi made a console and they called it the Zero. And then they did a surprise console launch of like Hawaii.
Oh, that would be great.
God, that would be so insensitive, but amazing at the same time. And I'm like, God, I wish they would do that. But Mitsubishi would probably
don't
never
give
do it.
I feel like surprise unveiling.
Surprise unveiling in Pearl Harbor.
Somehow, you know, when they're going for the test drive, accidentally crashed into some pedestrians.
or
accidentally crash into an 18-wheeler.
Just,
that would maybe be the equivalent, right?
For whatever reason, the Mitsubishi new console Zero just seemed to crash into an American aircraft carrier. Really odd, but yeah.
It's like, oh shit, we're running out of gas. You gotta go in the gas station. No, I have a better idea. Oh no, you just crashed right into that truck.
Oh, truck.
Well, that would be amazing.
But for whatever reason, I had a random daydream. Mitsubishi doing that because I'm like, why is it Mitsubishi never pursued a console market kind of approach? Like, I know, like, they have all that control of like Japanese mineral industry and like some other aspects of it, but they also like manufactured TVs and other stuff, kind of like Sony. So it's like, why didn't they kind of follow that suit? I don't know why.
You know, so actually, the first TV I ever bought in Japan was a Mitsubishi, and I was like, I just thought it was cool. I was like, oh, I got a Mitsubishi TV. It was a good little TV, too.
Yeah, I don't know. It's just kind of weird, because, like, Mitsubishi, they, like, I feel like they fell out of the tech industry, like, in the late 90s, like, at least in North America, anyway.
It's weird, because they have, like, 8,000 different divisions that make everything, right?
Yeah.
It's funny, because, like, one of the biggest pencil makers in Japan is Mitsubishi. Like, they're, like, a classic pencil maker because of all the mineral stuff you're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, of course they're going to make pencils, but it's just weird seeing, you know, when you come over and you're just used to, like, Mitsubishi... You know, cars and all that stuff, mm-hmm. right? Like, oh, there's a fucking pencil that says Mitsubishi.
No, I just remember, like, primarily, like, when I was a kid, I was like, Mitsubishi big screen! Like, that reprojection TV stuff.
I don't remember like, that, no, but no, I remember like, projection TVs, but I didn't know it was Mitsubishi.
Yeah, like, Mitsubishi was always, like, the big screen TV type, like, format back in the day.
Okay.
And they just fell out of it. I don't know what happened. Let's see, I personally would not touch anything that's not Toyota or Hyundai, unless
Guys responding to Colin, get a Ford Falcon.
No, I kind of, like, I don't know, I find, like, just because my family's been getting bigger and, like, I've been researching stuff in Mitsubishi and, like, their warranty plans for, like, their cars are just crazy good.
Yeah.
That's my drive. So, like, tomorrow, like, depending on what time you think you're streaming?
Just the usual time. I was thinking about doing either one of two things. One is, like, maybe Nintendo 8-bit, but that's kind of boring. So I thought about getting all 8 million of my PlayStation games out and doing a PlayStation stream.
That'd be fun.
And just whatever. We'll see how long that lasts. Forever.
That could, yeah. But God, that was so nice. Like, the, when you streamed the last round, I was just like at work. I'm like, yeah, like, this is great. Because like, it's great. Like, it was a federal down day, so like no one else was in the office. So I was like, fuck, just bullshit with y'all.
Yeah, so it's almost kind of like, you know, you don't have anything to drink, but
yeah, that kind of sucked, but yeah.
But I'll help you to help you, you know, pass the time. Yeah. To get a limo, plenty of seats. He already has a limo. On loan from big time YouTuber Yahel Velasquez. The 60 hours is so fast.
Yeah, no, if you, because you watch Red Letter Media, right?
I do.
Yeah, I was talking to Yahel, we were discussing an idea. I'm like, yeah, what if we do something like, do a video series called, like, Replay or something like that, where we, like, sit down and just talk about, like, video game movies and our feelings about those.
Oh, that'll be fun.
I think it would be really fun to sit down and do something like that.
Start off with, like, Super Mario Brothers, because that was the first really huge one.
That would be a good one.
And then, like, you gotta have somebody to be, like, the hipster who's like, it's actually really not that bad.
Yeah, because I think we were talking about, I don't know, I think this got started with us, like, we were talking about Picard, the new CBS Star Trek.
I was gonna ask you, because I saw the Red Letter Media video on that finally the other day. They didn't like it too much.
Well, I don't know, like, they, I don't know, I didn't mind it that much, but then again, like, I feel like I'm probably, like, domestically abused in terms of my relationship with Star Trek. So, like, I mean, like, ultimately,
and Star,
like,
Wars.
Yeah, and Star Wars for the most part. So, like, it's one of those things where you don't necessarily. How do you describe it? I don't know. I didn't feel like Discovery was absolutely a train wreck, dumpster fire. So, like, that was just bad. But Picard, I feel like it wasn't that bad, because I feel like they actually have a predetermined plan for what they're doing. Mm-hmm. So at least I'm kind of entertained. It's characters I like, and it's kind of like some fun ideas.
Yeah.
So I'm only two episodes in at this point. So, I mean, it wasn't too bad so far, but we'll see. Like, but then again, I kind of agree with them in terms of how they're talking about how the Federation is just getting absolutely neutered and destroyed by.
Well, that was,
by the current showrunners.
Yeah, that part where Rich was like about to cry because he was talking about the old Star Trek where Abraham Lincoln calls Uhura a Negro, but she doesn't even like realize. Oh, should I be offended?
Yeah,
it's like that's like, you know, that vision of the future where like everyone's so past this stuff, but now it's all about, oh, let's make this contemporary. Let's talk about what's going on, and all these hack writers who have the knowledge.
Yeah, I mean, like it's one of those things where like.
Star
Trek used to have a way of like analyzing current events and making it beyond what we perceive. Like they would take it and then make it more grandiose. And like now they said this way, like it's got to be like now and in your face. You're like, come on,
right.
you can do
who's gonna relate? Yeah, because it's, you know, maybe the audience is bigger and stupider. Who knows? But you know what happened though? I got Netflix for the first time in 8 years the other day. One of the first things I added on there was Star Trek Next Generation. The very first thing I put in there was Dave Chappelle stuff. But but I'm gonna go to the gym and just watch all the Star Treks.
TNG is fantastic to watch when you run on a treadmill.
Yeah, I imagine it's just like it was like basically an hour each. And
freaking great! Like, because I'd always like. Whenever I'm on a treadmill, I'm always on a treadmill for about a half hour running.
Yeah.
So that's usually the best way to do that. Oh, come on.
I might do bike and, like, elliptical.
Oh, God, elliptical's nice. It's It's like a lazy. It's a lazy man's treadmill. It's fantastic.
It's a lazy man's treadmill, and it looks like you burn twice as much calories in on the bike. So it's great.
Yeah. Yeah. And see, it's like instead of the knee impact, was it?
Yeah, and then if you have like bad knees, then my knees are still good, thankfully. So I haven't been jumping up and down in excitement over like CDI homebrew games like you have. So
yeah. Oh my god, I don't. Yahel has all this.
I'm just saying.
I think Yahel actually owns.
Stomping my feet on the ground, like, why can't I get Saturn to notice me?
See, Honda has a great warranty as well. Pretty much decent cars. Yeah, it was. I've been looking at Mitsubishi because they have the Outlander has the 3-seat model, and it's like $15,000 less than pretty much every other car manufacturer in terms of offering that variety. And it still has like 5-star safety ratings and just about everything. That's kind of nice.
Yeah, techs—the old quote-unquote woke thing. It's very sad. Everybody's just trying to look at me. Aren't I such a good person?
No, well, yeah, it's not. Just like
you're worse than the people you're talking about half the time.
Yeah, like Star Trek Discovery is what you get when you hire a writer's room of people who are only capable of writing BuzzFeed headlines.
Exactly. That's like the woke mecca. Oh, got a super chat.
Oh, Dev. Thanks, man. I appreciate that. Now if you're throwing 32X games out there, keep it up, man. Will do, man.
That's cool.
But yeah, I'm up to like 3.5 pages on the TurboGrafx script, so we'll see how that one goes.
No, okay, good. Yeah, I finished. I'm almost finished. I gotta add a couple more things, but I'm at 8 pages for this Goemon video.
Jesus, like a 40-minute video.
It'll probably be like 20, 30 minutes, maybe.
Oh wow.
Yeah, it's just, I don't know. There's a lot of stuff to talk about, or a lot of stuff that I want to talk about in these stupid videos. That's why, like, I get discouraged for writing things. I was like, oh shit, this is gonna be like in the old days. Like, I could do three pages. Oh. Not anymore. And I'm not even going super detailed into like the story because that would just be a waste of time.
Ryuga said, "Man, you got wrecked." Yeah, I'm really bad at Street Fighter 2. Like, I can play Street Fighter 3. Oh, no, sorry. Oh my god. I am
drunk. How drunk are you from these cocktails?
Yeah, apparently they're just wrecking my ass. Holy crap.
That's okay.
Yeah, like, I can play Mortal Kombat 3, I can play. But man, apparently Mortal Kombat 2 is just hard. God, this version looks great, though. I'll say that.
It looks alright. You don't have a Virtua Fighter for 32X, do you?
I do, actually. I'll probably switch to that here in a sec, because I'm getting wrecked. Yeah. But, you know, my Mortal Kombat main is actually Sector, for the most part. Because I can play him pretty effectively in Mortal Kombat 3. But, man, yeah.
If I was going to be playing that super hot Melina without the mask. Oh, boy. Let's see this, Is your game frozen, or...?
Is it?
Talking, okay, yeah, because I can't tell because obviously I don't have the volume.
Oh, I want it, Shang Tsung. Yeah. Good to go. You ever seen Shang Tsung?
Dude, you know what game I want to get? Ironically and unironically at the same time? It's Sub-Zero.
Oh, the N64?
For N64 or PlayStation. The MK...
Oh, no.
Is it MK Mythologies or whatever the hell it was called?
Yeah,
I remember when it came out, it sounded like it would be a really cool game. It's a side-scrolling platformer, action platformer, and then you like see it, it's like, oh, this is terrible. How do you fuck that up? You make it like something, like make it like Shinobi or something, right? How could you fuck this up?
Ooh, Mortal Kombat 2, we're going to switch to Virtual Fighter, because man, I'm bad at this. Oh. We can switch to Cosmic Carnage, which is a really grab painful a couple game. More. That's such a good Virtual Fighter for a while. Yeah. So it was funny, for Christmas, one of my brothers bought me that, like, the arcade 1-up Street Fighter cabinet. So he bought me then he bought my...
Oh, really?
Then he bought my other brother the Mortal Kombat
the Mortal Kombat version of that. And I'm like, oh man, I wish you got me the Mortal Kombat one, because I'm actually good at Mortal Kombat. I suck at Street Fighter.
Yeah, I saw over in Japan Costco they were selling the Pac-Man one, but I would really like the Ninja Turtles one.
Yeah, I saw that one. I'm like, ooh, I might have to get that.
I'm going to look on Amazon Japan, see if they're selling that. I'm going to meet up with Avalanche Jared in like in a week and a half, though.
Oh, is he coming out there?
So I got to, yeah, I got to keep my purchases down.
Is he going to Tokyo or?
Well, they were going to come down and visit me in Sendai, but they couldn't find a Airbnb down here because there was one. It's not really Airbnb country anyway, but obviously in Tokyo you're going to find a lot. So I'm going to go down there and stay with them for a few days. And
okay. I thought with the whole
I had one extra day off that I could take. If I died, it's bound to happen.
I think the whole coronavirus would be like really cheap and easy to find a place to stay.
Right?
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe they're doing all right. Maybe they can get a discount. But yeah, I'll do that and just hang out for a few days. Get into a few fights. Yeah. Good times.
But yeah, it's okay. You got a bouncer with you, so you're fine.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's going to make me feel more emboldened. Because if I start getting into a fight and I can't handle it, Jared,
have I? Gosh, God.
Yes. Go see.
I've been aboard like a shoe.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Should be pretty good, though.
That guy just took half my health with the freaking suplex. Oof. Oh, God.
By the way, just a dorky name for a character in a fighting game. Jeffrey!
Jeffrey!
It's like the Queen's butler.
Jeff! Reginald! Wow,
I saw that finally, yeah. That guy just screwed you up.
Ooh.
See, Diff's talking about mythologies. Yeah, that was like Volume 1. I think they had like plans to do it for everybody, but then they realized, I guess, well, nobody bought the game. I remember it got panned in all the magazines.
Yeah, which game?
Mortal Kombat Mythologies.
Oh, yeah.
Sub-Zero.
I feel like it was like Mortal Kombat after... I feel like any console port of Mortal Kombat after Mortal Kombat 3 just got all no ends of shit.
Like a no end?
Well, I don't know. I feel like I'm also very drunk at this point, so I apologize. the way my memory is remembering Mortal Kombat was like pretty much anything after Mortal Kombat 3, like that was brought to the console was like universally panned, with the exception of the Mortal Kombat game that came out later that had like an RPG element to it as well. Remember what I'm talking about?
I don't remember which one that is, but it was a few. There were a few iterations that were just like Mortal Kombat's over.
Yeah.
And nowadays, like the past what 5 years or so, Mortal Kombat's been really hot again. But
yeah, it came back. They're like, you know what? We're going back to 2D just fighting game mechanics, and we're just doing that. And everyone's like, yeah, this is what we wanted.
It's almost like a cultural phenomenon again because they have all like the. Horror characters like as downloadable characters and shit, right? Yeah. So it's kind of like this big thing that all these young people are playing.
Hey, Sonomaru, what's up, man?
Ian. Is that a shout or is that a whisper in the ear?
Did you guys, when he was in Japan, you link up at all or no?
Nah, this motherfucker doesn't come over to hang out with me. He comes over to go eat takoyaki in Osaka or something. I don't know. I ain't got words with Sonomaru anymore. Done with that guy. Done with that freak. We beefing.
I can't remember.
Maybe Kobe beefing, except I ain't going down to Kobe. Mortal Kombat Special Force. That's... Oh my god. The one with Jax. Metal arm guy.
No.
Well, I'm slightly impressed by this game on 32X, but...
Yeah, I mean, it's not bad.
They did it on Saturn twice.
Well, you know... I mean, Saturn has particular advantages to it that the Genesis / 32X wouldn't have.
know, the greatest console of all
time.
But
I will say I have a better experience playing this on the Grid 2X than the Saturn. That's just how I feel about it.
This we already got you exposed for being an Andy Kaufman-esque con man. This is a social experiment. Stop it. Son of mine, we never linked at the tips because you had that third wheel Jesse around. Saturn version is better. Colin, you would know. You have all the virtual fighters now. And nice polygonal 3D graphics. That's right. Especially on the Saturn, though. 480 with Virtual Fighter 2. 480i.
I always love how Japanese games have to include blood type.
Yep. It's a big part. You know, your blood type determines what kind of person you're going to be. Whether or not you're going to be a loser.
So, that one girl, I was looking at her, she's an AB. But I'm like, is she AB positive or negative? It can't just be AB.
I don't think it matters in weirdo Japan land, but that's Sarah.
As an AB positive person myself, I feel like they should have included that.
Okay. How dare you?
I know. I'm just saying, as a... I don't know. It seems to be like I was reading somewhere where like Japan apparently is utterly obsessed with blood types, just based on it being aspect of.
It's like a personality determination or whatever determiner.
Yeah. So like. So I thought it was kind of
like,
cool because
it's like astrology type bullshit.
Yeah.
Oh, text $10 for the TurboGrafx-16 video.
Oh, thanks, man. Appreciate that. Yeah, I'm hoping I'm up like 3.5 pages or so on that thing, and I'm hoping to have it's gonna be like 6 pages, so I'm thinking it's gonna be like a 30-minute video.
You know, all that $10 is gonna do though is it's gonna slow you down because you're gonna buy booze with it and get drunk and not do anything. So everybody, if you want to delay his Turbo Graphics further, keep giving him money. Bring it in.
Go ahead and Spoonie experiment that thing and just don't do it.
Can we get him to $5,000 Patreon? Can we spoonie this? Can we shelve this spoon? Let's see if we can.
No, but I'm pretty happy that the video's coming out for the most part. Should be interesting.
If I remember correctly, though, the blood type thing, A is for serious people, B is for people who are like out more extroverted and fun-loving, O is for weirdos, and A, B is like a mix of A and B. I think? I don't remember exactly. I don't mind it. It's just kind of like if you ask me, like, well, you're a Capricorn. Whoa. What does that mean? I don't know. It means that in Final Fantasy Tactics, I do more damage to cancers and vice versa. That's what it means to me. That's the only reason I ever fucking looked it up.
Texas, buy more beer.
Yep, buy more beer. He just wants that. He's waiting 2021.
Thanks, man. I appreciate that.
The year of TurboGrafx 2021. It was actually, you know, the Turbo, I was going to say 20XX, but actually, if you think about it, now it's 20XX.
Oh, God.
It's 2020, baby.
So we're in Street Fighter XX now?
Oh, shit. Oh, God, where aren't people floating around in space? No difference between positive or negative and positive? I don't know.
The one thing I do like, though, being...
It's only when you get blood.
So being AB positive in the army, it's kind of great for me. Because, like, if I ever get hit, so anyone who has a positive blood type, I can take. So I'm like, I'm like, give me that blood.
But you know what it's going to do, though? It's going to make you feel like you're more like Superman. I can take a few bullets. Shit, let's go on the front line.
I'm like, I am, all right, give me that I blood am transfusion. Fine. So don't you worry about me.
Yep. You don't have to, like... You know, you get hit, and you're like gonna trick one of your friends with like O blood type, O negative or something. And be like, go out there, man, avenge me, bring back your blood, so I can take it.
God, Virtual Fighter is so weird. Like, I feel like the hit values for some things are way higher than other games.
It's like the most technical fighter ever created. I think that was like the big. Big tagline or whatever, what people used to say about it. I don't know. But the thing about Virtual Fighter is it's I think in certain eras, it was the more popular fighter than Street Fighter even.
Oh, yeah. I remember reason why the Saturn became as 3D powerful as it did was because how successful Virtual Fighter was.
Yep. Also, Inigo is giving you $2 to mock you.
Jeffrey's kicking my ass.
That the queen's bodyguard can't even take down this ninja. That ninja looks pretty skinny, though.
Let's switch to Jeffrey.
We
will become Jeff to defeat Jeff.
Can't beat him, be him. Virtual Fighter was... Sarumaru, you should know this. Virtual Fighter was a cultural phenomenon. When Virtual Fighter 3 came out, that was the thing that was supposed to save the Dreamcast. It didn't. But the arcades were fucking packed. Bro, come on. You know this.
Wow, apparently Jeffrey cannot dodge his own fists.
Yep. He's shocked.
Yeah, he's like, oh my god!
He's also dressed like Hiro Yui from fucking, what do you call it? Gundam Wing. If you remember how he looked. The green tank and the gray pants.
Oh god, I hated him.
Hiro Yui! I was like Duo.
I was always more of a Duo guy.
Yeah, he was like, why isn't this guy the main character? Hiro sucks.
Fucking Duo is awesome with the fucking dual minigun fucking Gundam.
Yeah, even the blonde French kid, who was probably gay. Let's be honest.
Oh yeah, like a blonde French guy with the fucking gigantic faux hawk thing. Yeah.
No, he was the pretty boy one.
Oh,
It was that guy who looked like he should have been an SNK fighter. Yeah.
Yeah.
I forgot about him. I used to have a little pin of that little French gay kid. I just love it. Is this the Say Wrestler talking?
Wrestler.
Lots of WWE dojins. I'm sure he did. Or ooh. Jimmy Racist Lava. Yes. That's me. That's me. I actually am racist. I can vouch for Ian not being racist at all.
Yeah. So,
any complaints?
Yeah, so I finished Man in the High Castle. Because that was where I learned what Hoppa meant. And I was like, oh shit. See what Jimmy did there.
There you go. Is this the Amazon or Netflix show, or is this the book?
Amazon Prime.
Okay. Yeah.
I can't read.
Pretty good. Maybe it's right.
I can't read.
Sorry, I knew they all banged. If you said, when you say doujinshi, see, yeah. 6A wrestling with gaming. Oof. Oh, that's London Vice, Sam. London Vice is falling down. like the Michael Douglas movie. Be careful. Don't ever meet him at a convention. He might be the first one to pull out his AR-15.
Ooh.
Where are all the CDI games? Where are all the CDI games? You shoot all the people, they're not going to be able to go to your CDI panel. Yeah, hell. Well, actually, you know what? They weren't going to go either way.
God damn it.
Keep going.
It's 1 a.m. currently for me. I think it's probably, what, like, noon?
5 p.m.
Oh, wow. How is Japan at 5 p.m.?
Right now, at least where I'm at, cold. And a little bit light outside, but it's going to be dark soon. The weapon of mass satisfaction. Oh, God. Oh, every woman's fantasy.
Oh, yeah, that video.
Oh god!
I've only seen these because people share this on my Discord. I don't know why.
I'll tell you what. I watched before Yahel removed all his wrestling videos. I did watch a few of them, and when he was like doing his matches, obviously he's like playing a cocky heel, but he got a lot of cheers from kids. London Vice, London. I was like, oh god, that's embarrassing. He was the John Cena of the indie circuit where only the kids gave a shit about him.
That's funny.
Sendai is always gold.
Holy shit, it's like 3/4 of my life with a freaking back kick.
I gotta
dude,
catch
like,
up.
Watch this. Like, this is freaking all of it.
Now you're playing as Wolf?
Yeah, the weird haircut guy.
Yeah, well, I can't. Unfortunately, button mashing isn't going to help you out in this game.
Yeah, it really won't. You got enough moves. It's woefully unfair. Woefully unfair.
Sam, I learned English from all the Japanese tourists. I was going to do an English accent, but I'll save it for your stream.
Okay.
3:01 a.m. Oh, shit. All right, Dev SWZ is making comic shit.
Well,
it's making it bearable.
I feel bad, guys, but it's about a bit over 1 a.m. my time, so I've been going for about 3.5 hours. So I'm going to go ahead and probably end the stream by now. I appreciate, Jimmy, you hopping on when you did.
Problem.
But definitely want to thank you guys for dropping by. I hope you guys have a fantastic evening or night or whatever you're doing. But yeah, all right.
All right, take it easy.
All right, bye, guys. And I can't seem to find my mouse wherever it is. So I can't end the stream, apparently. But all right, you guys have a nice night. Ah, dirty game room. Sorry, man. I was just about to end the stream. But all right. But you guys have a great night. I'll catch you later. All right, bye.
Good night, guys.